Hi everyone, I'm Harshvardhan, an artificial intelligence engineer, and you're watching another WebGuy YouTube channel. And today we are going to build an advanced keylogger using Python. So let me demonstrate you what you will be building. So here we are on our keylogger.py file, and I'm just going to run this file. So at the end, I will write something. I will say, "Hi, I am Harshvardhan." Now let's see what we have written in the console. So here you can see that whatever we have written in the text file or the Python file is being printed out in the console. I have seen various keylogger projects and found that you're only taught how to log the keys. But just logging the key doesn't mean you have built your own keylogger. So let's have a look what is being logged. So here I will go to this log.txt, and here you can see that it's written something like key.enter, key.shift, then h as a character, then I as a character, and everything is written in such a haphazard way that you cannot understand what's written in just a single site. So even after getting the data to your device, you're not going to write all the characters on the paper to clean it, obviously. So to automate all the process, we have three different phases. At first, we will log the data. Secondly, we will send the data through email. And at last, we will clean the data. So let's get started. And if you have not yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. So to build a keylogger, we need a module called PyInput. So let's install that module first. So here in the Chrome browser, I will say PyInput, and you just have to select this very first link. Here I will copy this command, pip install PyInput. In the Visual Studio Code, I will just paste that command and I will execute it to install the PyInput module. Great. So I will just cross this console and I'll create a new file. I'll say key logger from scratch .py. So at first we will import the module. So let's say from PyInput, we are going to use keyboard, and we will import key and listener. We will create an object, say with listener. We'll pass two functions for on press, and for on press we are going to pass on press function, and for on release we are going to pass on release function. So this on press and on release function we are going to define later on. So we will say as listener, and here we will say listener dot join, and let's define these functions. We will say def on press. We will pass a parameter key, and we will say print that key. We will define another function called on release. We will again pass a parameter key, and we will say if key is escape key, then we will return false. Great. So let's understand what we are doing here in this code. We have imported key and listener from PyInput.keyboard. Now we have defined a listener that will execute two different functions. One is on press function, this one, and another is on release function, this one. So what is this on press and on release? On press, that means when you have pressed the key from your keyboard, and this on release is when you have released the key from the keyboard. So these two functions will be executed only when you press the key and when you release the key. And at last we are saying listener.join. So there is a concept of thread. So we are just joining listener thread with the main thread. Not required for this project. Okay. So here what we will doing, we are just printing the key that are being pressed to the console. And if we have pressed the escape key, so here you can see that this K is capital and I'm talking about this key, so key dot escape. So if the key pressed is the escape key, then we are going to return false. That means we are going to break the loop. And from where we are going to get this key argument, this listener will automatically provide these two arguments. That means this key. So let's execute this file. And now I'm going to write something. So I'll say, hi, I am Harshvardhan. So here you can see that in the console, at first I have used shift, then hi, then space, then shift, then I, again space, then am, then again space, and then Harshvardhan. So at the end, I will just press escape to exit the loop. So after pressing the escape, you can see that we are out of the loop and now our file is no more executing. So let's cross this console. I will remove this, save the file. Now we will create a list called keys. Why this list? So that we can store all the keys that are being pressed. So instead of logging that key, we will say keys.append and we will pass key. So each and every key that are being pressed will be saved in this list. Great. So at the end, we will just print keys. So when this print statement will be executed, only when you have pressed the escape key. Great. So let's save the file and run it. And now I'm going to write at the end, I will write anything. So again, I write, hi, I am building a key logger. Great. So escape. And at the end, you can see that we got a list which contained all the keys that are being pressed by you when you are running this file. Great. I will remove this content. And now we want to save that list to a file. So for this, what I will do, I will remove this print statement. I will say with open log.txt, that means we are going to create a log file in a writing mode as file, and we are going to say file dot write lines, and we are going to say string form of keys. That means each and everything will be written in a string form. So a list will be printed or saved in the log file in a form of string. Great. So let's execute this file again. And at the end, I will say I have built or written a text file. Great. And I will just press escape. Now let's have a look on log.txt. You can see that at first I have pressed space, then shift, then I, then space, then have, then again space, then written, then space, then backspace, 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 then n, space. So you can see that we have written the file and or written the keys that are being pressed to the log file. Great. Now we want to send this data through email. How we'll do that? We will use this sendemail.py file that I have explained to you in the previous project, that how you can send the email using Python. So what we will do, I will just remove this line and here say from send email, we are going to import send email. Great. So when we have pressed the escape, we want to send the email. So we will say send email function to execute. Great. Save the file and let's go to this sendemail.py file. So this sendemail.py file, we will use Gmail to create a session with your email and password that are saved in this CRUD file. So in this CRUD file, you just have your email and password. So we will log into your Gmail account using this email and this password. We will open the log file in the reading mode, read the data, and we will send the data through your email to your email or any other email. And at the end, we will just print email sent. By the way, I have given a detailed explanation project on this. You can take a look on that. Great. I'll just cross that. And now, instead of sending the email, because currently we are working on a local machine, I will comment this out. We want to clean the log file because this is not a human readable format. So now we have to clean the log file. How we'll do that? For this, we are going to say from klcleaner, we are going to import clean function. So what is this klcleaner? Klcleaner is this file that I have built for you to clean the logged keys or the text that are being saved in this log.txt file. And in this klcleaner, we have a clean function that we are going to look later on, but let's understand how this will work. So at first, what we are doing, we are defining two functions. One is onPress and onRelease. And if the key is escaped, we are going to save all the data present in this keys list to a log file called log.txt. And then we are going to break out of the loop by using return false. Okay, so after I have sent the email or I have received the file, I will just say clean. So this will not be executed at the source, that means from the remote device from where you are gathering the information. This will be executed only on your own device so that you can get what is written inside this log.txt file. So let's execute this. Again, I will write something. I'll say, hi, I am building a key logger. I'll press escape. So here you can see that what I have written here is being printed out in the console. I apologize for this spelling mistake, but doesn't matter. What is the important thing is that whatever here it is written is being printed out in this console. But if you see the log file, it is something that cannot be read at just a glance, right? So let's learn how this cleaner file will work. This I have given a well-commented, well-documented file for you. At first, what we are doing, we are going to open the log file. So at first, we are going to open the log file. And then we are going to replace the space with the empty string. So let's have a look on log.txt. Here you can see that we have various space. So this is a space, this is a space. So there are various space, right? Because everything is in form of a string, not a form of list. So now at first, what we will do, we will remove unnecessary spaces. And then we are going to say, if there is a space, that means key dot space, then replace that with the physical space or that can be printed. And then we have created a very easy regular expression that will capture all the keys present in the log file. That means like key.shift, key.escape, enter, these kind of keys will be taken out by using this regex key. And now we are replacing the keys using re.sub. Sub is means substitute. So instead of this regex key, we are going to say a empty string. And where we have to replace? We have to replace in the message variable. So we are just replacing all the keys with empty string. And then what we are doing? We are just replacing the apostrophes by empty string. So we are just replacing these things with the empty string. At the end, we are going to replace comma with the empty string. So here you can see that we have so many comma at the end of each element in a particular list that we were built in the file. That means this keylogger from scratch.py here in keys list. So we are just going to remove that comma and then we will print the message. So that's how our keylogger cleaner is working. So that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one.